So I'm suggesting, how about don't play Lundre at all. Just play something else on Mage.
But it was good in the first game, though.
Yeah, but then if you want to pick a carry for Envy, then I think you shouldn't do that, right?
Why doesn't he just play safe on Lundre?
Oh, on Envy?
Yeah.
Have they ever done that?
I don't know. But so. We might have an answer soon. Sounds like we have Game 3 draft ready to go. Let's hop into it, and maybe these questions will be answered. It's Team Secret versus Evil Geniuses Game 3.
Good job, Dakota.
I'm trying. It's so hot in here. All right, so it looks like EG are going there to be on the dire side, and Secret will be taking first pick on the Radiant, and it does look like EG were the team that won the flip, and with that flip advantage, they took the Dire.
This is actually very interesting. So EG banned both junglers, and Secret, with first pick, banned the Earth Spirit that they picked the last two games. So definitely a change of pace here.
Wait, what? They banned Earth Spirit on their first pick?
Yeah.
All right.
Maybe they hoped they would get Enigma without turning Earth Spirit in the turn.
Yeah, I guess that's true, because Enigma was second banned. Yeah, that's true. They wanted to go back for the Enigma, more or less.
But this is where I wonder if they should have tried to go for what we talked about, where you just, you could have just gone for, Okay, that's a little bit distracting, that's okay. If they could have just gone for the setup where they prioritize Enigma over Earth Spirit, they could have maybe done that.
Look at that, Dakota. Prophet.
Nature's Prophet, he finally shows up. I mean, it was the last game made it the fifth time we didn't see Nature's Prophet picked or banned whatsoever, but finally one of these teams had to take the bite, and EG are going to revert back to what we saw from game 1. The Darkseer for the third time straight will be their first pick option, and their follow-up will be the Mighty Sven.
Similar opening in the first game, and EG got so much fun from the Ancients that game, so I wonder if Seeker are going to change up their strats, maybe pick some heroes that can actually focus more on like scouting the Ancients. I think we mentioned Beastmaster earlier, but I'm not sure if Seeker actually does a support Beastmaster or a safe lane Prophet, so I'm not sure if they can actually do that. But they're just going to go back for their typical like Lion. Like, this hero has been like picked as a support position so much in the last 2 days.
It's still got a pretty good win rate, I would imagine.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a Secret classic, specifically in this major. I believe counting game 1, this would be their fifth Lion showing with a 4-1 record. But again, Secret seem to be a team that doesn't prioritize getting something like the Oracle, let's say, to completely shut down the Darkseer.
Yeah, and the Sven is also a really good hero. I think one of the better carries against the Prophet offlane, because you can get a Quelling Blade early, and then you have the Cleave, you deal with the Treants very well. So it's not going to be an easy time for the Prophet in the offlane. So they ban out the Bat, which, I mean, I don't... It's still something that's it's going to help the Sven, despite the Bat not having a very good performance in the game 1. But it's still one of the heroes that would help Sven actually lock down targets, and is good versus the Prophet. A good replacement would be Puck. Oh, do you like Puck this game for them on EG?
Tough for Lion.
But it's a good replacement for the role that the Bat Rider offers in that game. Like, you want to have a hero that can lock down the enemy target, so your Sven can actually do his thing in teamfight.
I'm still down with Magnus, man.
Magnus?
Yeah. It's a Sumail hero.
Speaking of Sumail's hero, I know this seems like it's out of left field, but is there ever in any world or dimension where he could go back for Storm Spirit once again?
Not this.
The hero is just done, and it's just not the right time.
Not this world.
Maybe
not
next this world, huh? Maybe next year. Maybe.
Next year? Okay.
Maybe next year.
Condolences.
I mean, they did try it once, I think.
They won with it at Frankfurt.
Yep. Yeah.
No, it started like that as well, didn't they? Pick it once.
I love this Sumail beanie.
It's not even old enough to vote, right?
It's so good. It is so good.
I suspect the Puppy Enchantress might not be an option for them this time. It wasn't banned, but...
I think if they want to choose to pressure the Sven early, Enchantress could be a good option if they want to do that. And it's still a jungling hero, which I think is much better placed off for Secret. Every time when I see Secret, they don't get the two junglers or the three junglers, they go back for the Dazzle. That's what Puppy would play if he doesn't get the jungler. And I always prefer that Secret be on that aggressive mode with the junglers. I feel their early game would go much better. They can control the enemy lanes better.
He plays Mirana too.
Mirana?
He used to. Not so much dispatch, but it is the one once you hear that escape the bands that was banned out in the first couple of games.
When you say this is a good Earthshaker game as well? Compared to Dazzle, at least.
It's still better than Dazzle, but at the same time, I don't feel like Earthshaker like can actually help the lanes out that much this game. I'm not sure.
You don't think Lion plus potential Nature's Prophet is strong enough to deal with the Darkseer? I guess it depends on what.
But it depends whether the Darkseer is alone. Or, like, you don't know if the Darkseer is gonna have like a Tusk with him or someone else with him, or even a Night Stalker.
I think you know after this pick, they have a tendency to pick some males here or last, so
yeah.
You can start planning for it after this one.
Speaking of mid laners, it's obvious we will, for the first time this series, not see Weehaw and his precious Earth Spirit. They got the Invoker, which is always a popular pick for Secret. Five picks, 3-2 this tournament. So, possible double Necro book, I guess, if you put it in tandem with a Nature's Prophet figure. But, oh, look at this. Nick's Assassin coming out. We saw it. What was it yesterday? The day before?
Yeah. It's the replacement they chose for the bat. I know we mentioned Puck, but this hero in this situation is really good versus the Prophet, is really good versus Invoker. And definitely one versus one mid. You just need Moment Shield to start the lane with it. You do really well against Invoker. Either Crossfax or Exile doesn't matter. Nyx just does really well against that.
Do you guys just think Corlina isn't good anymore? Because I thought they have really good synergy with it. It's one of Samael's best heroes. The hero just does pretty well in lane against Invoker. Is it too fragile against Nature's Prophet because of that they didn't get it?
Don't you think, like, if you talk about catching the Prophet, Nyx actually does it better?
Yeah, for sure. It's better for the catch.
And in team fights, you probably have more chance to actually lock down more heroes for this Ven. So I think that could also be another consideration. That's why they went for the Nyx. They would rather sacrifice a little bit of the laning phase, go for a hero that doesn't do so well in the lane, but offers more for the Sven.
There's absolutely no doubt that Nyx is an extremely good pick here and good against all the enemy heroes. There's also three intel heroes that Monoburn just destroys, especially Invoker. If he goes Exort, he just gets so much intelligence from that. So I think it's a great pick. I was just curious because I don't remember seeing EG pick at this entire tournament, and it used to be a Samael classic that he played extremely well at TI5.
This is the second game they pick it, right? Yeah, the first game was against Fnatic.
Yeah, the Nyx is the second time. But the only team that, the only teams, I guess, that still stuck with Alina that played it at TI5 and did very well were Virtus Pro and CDC. I actually still played it on G and Sheiky respectively, but EG have moved one step away from it, it would seem.
So Secret are going to go for their vision control here.
Iron to the jungle.
I want to say Nightstalker actually has a pretty bad win rate this tournament so far. I want to look it up here for myself. I don't want to go as far as to say he has not received a win yet, but it is close.
He has one for Liquid.
He has one.
Played Night Stalker.
Do you think Iron Talon jungle is the way this game? Instead of just going for the laning phase, you do dual lanes with Prophet and you pressure the Sven?
Iron Talon jungle.
Okay.
Yeah, babe.
That's my vote. I think they have MP, so I think you can just run around at level 4 and put enough pressure to compensate for your early.
So, Night Stalker roam at the you Iron Talon jungle, and then first night you roam, and then Prophet TP scene for kill. That sounds good.
Yeah, you gotta try and hit Nyx before 6, and then you have the Lion to pressure the Darkseer enough. I guess, what shall MV play though?
If you're Talon jungling with NS this game, then you need a strong safe laner to go with Lion to compensate, to counter out Darkseer. Lion is one of the weaker supports in against Darkseer in the first few levels. He has bad stats, doesn't really deal very much damage, can't
Klinks
mess with the equilibrium or anything.
Klinks is okay.
Slark is good.
Yep. Alright.
Very good suggestion. I like that.
So if EG thinks that Team Secret might actually do that, would you think that going for a Tusk with the Darkseer could pressure the safe lane a lot? Especially against the Lion. Do you think that would be a good idea?
The unfortunate thing is that they don't have the 10th pick. If they had the absolute last pick and they saw an opening, they could do it. But it can backfire really hard if they end up picking, say, something like a Gyro for Eternal Envy, then that hero is just so good against
them. So the safer choice would probably be going for a jungler. What other junglers are okay? I guess Doom was the last one, because they typically run Beastmaster or Doom jungling.
Here comes the Legion Commander.
Legion Commander
is actually pretty decent.
It's pretty good against these guys.
Yeah, if they stick to their game plan, it means that Fear is going to be on a roaming slash jungling hero, and which Legion Commander could fit?
Lifestealer?
Hacks, man.
Lifestealer?
Negative. He can infest the Nyx. That's
he can also assimilate the Nyx.
Oh, that would be cool.
That's cute.
Have you seen Nyx's axe?
Yeah.
Oh!
That's also good. Iron Talon Pugna, you... Okay, you don't.
The ward is really good against Invoker. Oh, man.
And Lion.
And Lion, yeah.
This is actually...
Wait, could this be a Call and Nyx support? No way, right? Nyx is definitely a Call. And Pugna is support.
They could easily run Nyx support.
They could do that, yeah?
Yeah.
Then that means what? Sumail plays the Pugna?
No, I think... Do you think it's possible?
It is definitely possible. It depends what they want to prioritize. Giving Nyx the mid lane will give them the fast possibility to roam, but giving Pugna the mid lane will increase their ability to take towers very early. And then it's about what they deem the most important. If they think it's a Nightstalker jungle with Talon, then this punishes the best, putting the Pugna mid probably, then take the towers early.
It is.
Man, Nyx is so good versus all those heroes, and they have Ember Spirit now. Okay, so Sumail is going to be playing the Pugna, and Nyx will be on the fall position. So, Iron Talon Nyx, I've tried that before, it's pretty good.
He has so much regen.
He has decent regen, decent armor.
Iron Talon is good on everyone.
What a dumb item.
What a dumb
Where's Bruno?
Item.
Alright, gentlemen, before we throw it over to the arena, how do you think this is going to go? Will EG stay in the upper bracket, or will they end up going down below?
I think this is a lot harder to call draft-wise, and we got Envy on Ember Spirit. If the prophecy comes true, then Envy will, in the most needed hour, he will prevail for his team.
Winter, Merlini, what do you guys think?
That was a good one, But I'm just going to go for Seeker because I think that the prophet might just get too... much from the laning phase, and he's gonna have a huge influence on the game.
I'll also go with Secret. I don't know what Pugna's doing there.
Alright, fair enough. We'll see which crafty draft is gonna be coming out with the win here. We throw it over to our casters now. It's Odie and Draskal.
And D, thank you very much, Kolgan. Here we have it. Secret versus EG has come down to this game 3 deciding matchup, and it's gonna be the time where Envy bringing out that Ember Spirit. And EG switching things up a little bit. Sumail, Pugna, and as they were talking about in the panel, Fear going to be put down on that position for Nyx Assassin.
I feel like the Pugna pick is probably just about the riskiest thing that we've seen EG do this entire series thus far. Just because it has the chance to not really secure them, the team fights in the late game per se. Like, if we look back at game 1 and 2, there was always significant teamfight potential on one side or the other. And honestly, this is the most skirmish-oriented kind of split-pushy game that we've seen thus far. So in that sense, I would actually give Secret the advantage. I think, like Winter was saying, the Furion is going to be able to get a lot out of his lane. You have good vision control with the Nightstalker, and just the ability to have a core that can fight on a consistent basis, has good mobility. I feel like EG are going to be lacking a bit in these skirmishes.
I mean, what do you think about the Nyx Assassin pick? That was something that the panel were saying is going to be really strong here for the side of EG because of, you know, the potential targets for the mana burn. And in terms of catching heroes out like the Nature's Prophet, do you feel that the Nyx Assassin was a smart pick here from EG?
I thought it was good when it was a core. Okay. Because we're going to see a stun here. So looks like it's just going to be some double rune here for
double
EG.
Double rune for EG.
Yeah, nice.
Alrighty.
But I did like the Nyx when I thought it was mid. When I see it as a support and I see the Pugna pick, I actually like the Nyx a little bit less because he's one of those heroes where if you're not consistently getting levels and, you know, contending in the core positions in terms of EXP, I think he has a much harder time having the kind of impact that they're going to need from him in this game. But they could also be just going with the idea that if Artur gets farmed enough on the spend, gets BKB at a decent timing, he can kind of just cleave through everyone on the side of Secret. And you do have that vacuum into Sven stun combo possibilities, so maybe they're just banking around some of that too.
Bottom lane trying to make a go here onto Universe. Of course, still just level 1, no Surge, so he won't need it. Still will be able to walk himself out of that one. Yeah, a lot of eyes on Sumail Pugna. I mean, what do EG have to achieve with this kind of lineup to win the game? What are we going to see them do? Is it going to be a similar kind of play style to game 2 or a little bit slower pace?
Well, if we're EG, we're looking to at least push towers. Like, you don't pick Pugna if you don't want to try to go for the tower push, right? The one thing is, I actually think Nether Ward is super good against Secret's lineup because all of their heroes are very spell-driven. Like, Invoker is a really good example. You have Lion, you have Ember Spirit, who even as a core has 4 active abilities that all cost a pretty decent chunk of mana. That part I get. It's just the fact that the hero is extremely fragile as a core, and I feel like They were talking in game number two on the panel about how Sumail has very limited success on heroes like Death Prophet, who kind of need their team and are very fragile in the early game. I feel like Pugna falls under that category, and he is less intimidating in a push than what I would say a Death Prophet is when you have Exorcism available.
Looking at the lanes at the moment, in terms of the last hits, MV 7 for 1 at the same time, Artur on the top lane, 7 for 3 on his Sven. Obviously we've seen Arteezy before on the Sven in game 1, had a very strong performance in terms of farm, wasn't enough to win them the game. This time they switched things around in terms of the heroes that are playing around it. And MV Ember Sprout, I mean, something that we've seen in the past, Secret pull out. They love it when it goes late with this hero, but at the same time, it's one of those heroes that one death in the later stages can cost the game, but it can, of course, be the game-winning hero if Envy can step up his performance here in game three.
I just like the fact that they didn't draft themselves a lineup that is insanely greedy, and Sumail mid.
Oh, Sunstrike straight on top of it. Misery joining in as well here. He'll decrep himself, drop down a blast. He'll ball himself up as well here. He'll actually deny the ward. Efficiency play there, you're not getting the gold for that one, but you're getting the gold for the kill, and first blood going to Pylai Dive.
Yeah, that was a very big kill, and again, who on the side of EG is going to help this mid? Like, this is a Pugna mid, and you have a Witch Doctor and a Nyx, but Fear kind of has to play it greedy. If a Nyx doesn't get levels, he's not going to contribute anything to this game. So the only person who can really help him is PPD, but PPD also needs to get his own experience, because if he's not being able to soak hold, he's never going to get his hands on Death Ward. Like, this lineup from EG might be the first one that I've seen in, like, the entire tournament where there's a pick that I just don't quite understand.
Misery on the offlane. He's found himself level 4 here, so things are going all right for him in that case. And Envy, he's getting a significant amount of space here. It's going to be a smoke up from Secret, Puppy and Pie. Nicky moved towards the mid lane. Not quite nighttime yet. We'll see if they can make anything happen. And they've already managed to take down Sumail once. If they can do it again, it could be pretty big. We know that Sumail, if you can shut him down early on, he can kind of be put on edge for the rest of the game, and Secret could be looking to try and break him here on the Pugna. He's still hanging around. He's going to have some backup this time. But no, sorry, it's not on his side. The backup's going for his Misery. It's the backup for Secret. And here goes Secret moving in onto Sumail. The Hex to follow him. Misery's there as well. Trapped in the trees. Sunstrike coming down on him here. And it's another kill onto Sumail. The crowd's loving it, and so Secret. Sumail, Pugna, 2 deaths at the moment in 4 minutes in. A lot of hate being sent his way by Secret.
Alright, so we've talked already about how the mid lane is extremely gankable, and it's been showcased 2 times right now by Secret in under 5 minutes. The question we have to ask ourselves now is, what's the trade-off? What are EG getting by pretty much sacrificing their mid player? And we can look and we see that Universe, he's getting okay farm. Like, it's alright, 4 minutes in, he's halfway to level 5, he's not doing too bad. And then, obviously, the Sven's gonna be free farming, which is also, it's fine, you know, this is what you should be getting out of the early game. But on this hero, like, how many times has Sumail played Pugna? I don't recall EG playing anything similar to this in the mid capacity for quite some time. And I feel like he's a bit out of his depth right now.
He's certainly struggling. And of course, someone who's not gonna be out of their depths, we are on the Invoker in the mid lane, one of his signature heroes. And so far, 25 for 11 against the 15 for 3, and obviously the involvement in 2 of these kills onto Sumail. Invoker, this is, it's lining up for Wii to have a good game off the back of this start.
Yeah, it's going to be very hard to stop this Invoker, especially given that EG's lineup, it can kind of roam, but it's not going to roam on any hero like Invoker. Typically, you need to roam for a mid who has kill potential, so either high burst damage or some kind of control. And you also need a support who contributes another one of those things, whereas, you know, throwing out a paralyzing cast can be great, but I don't think that they have good ways of controlling the laning phase with their supports. And we've already seen that Secret, Nature's Prophet, you know, Night Stalker, it's obviously nighttime, Pylai Dai and the Lion, their ability to move around the map and control the lanes is just far better.
PPD? I think that was intentional.
Yeah, it was.
He was out of money, wasn't he?
Yeah, he bought before he died, so it was definitely intentional. So, they are getting a decent
119 gold there, according to the fight recap.
Wait, what?
No, on the fight recap it shows 119
gold. He lost money?
Yeah.
Okay.
PPD? I mean, I know Sumail's died twice, but it's not that bad. Come on, hang in there, bloke. Come on, hang in, Peter.
No reason to go off the deep end.
Nope.
Not yet. But they are getting some decent farm. Like, we look to the Nyx. He's actually got quite a bit right now. He's halfway to level 5. We see a smoke up from the double support duo of EG. They want to try to go for a counterplay here. However, they don't have dust, so killing the Invoker is going to be tough.
Some mail, no, he could be a troll again, he does have the backup, the stun from Paralyte, could run to two. There's a backup from Universe coming in with the TP. The bouncers are there, Mystery TPing in, EG holding their own this time though. Looks like they won't lose anyone. Oh, they can't get puppies, night time, a little bit too tanky. So EG, they are able to keep some mail alive here. They don't quite find anything in return, but they'll be happy to keep the puck around the game.
It ended up being a let's look at each other and use all our spells and then walk away moment, which I think for EG is actually fine. In this situation, just not losing your mid again is going to be good enough. And the Sven, as we've seen in the previous games, he is getting completely out of control, 70 CS in a 7-minute game. Having 10 CS a minute at 7 minutes, I don't know how many games you're actually ever going to see that level of CS on a hero.
This is top of the board. See if Secret are able to try and put any attention towards that top lane to do something about this spec. We saw in game one how much RTZ can do when he gets a start like this. And of course he is going to have to rely on the rest of his team to step it up as well. Because at the moment, the three cores overall for the side of Secret just doing better in comparison.
The other issue that EG have is they kind of have this lineup where they have good damage once the Nyx hit 6, but prior to that, they really lack the ability of getting kills. So their lineup is a little bit greedy in that they need levels, but once they get them, they could definitely set up a lot of kills, and this is going to be heavily on the back of Fear. This guy's just about to hit level 6, he's got his arcanes ready. All he needs to do now is be with like one other hero with a disable or any kind of nuke, and he should be able to kill. Like, the Lion is a pretty quick pick. Pile I die, soaking bottom lane right now. I wouldn't even be surprised to see him rotate to that lane, knowing that he's probably just going to sit there and soak 6. But they do have some options now that their supports are getting up there.
Zep is going to be happy with this space halfway towards the blink. And as you mentioned, closing in on the ult. The Secret, I guess. Ooh, Jackie, keep it cool. 3 HP.
Calculated.
Come on, calculate, yeah.
Calculated.
All right. He knew. Jackie knew.
Of all the people in Dota, if we said he did the math, you would believe it if it was Jackie, right?
I'm sure you would. Top lane, EG, RTZ, Samael, and PPD. Ready to push with the God Strength and the Blast. Envy is there. And we do have the rest of Secret coming in. There'll be a TP out for Samael. Get it off. The chains aren't going to land on any of the heroes. Unfortunately, our Tor turning around the Storm Ally back. Just laying in onto Envy. PPD trying to move in as well with the Witch Doctor. But Weeheart is there with Puppy and Secret. They're going to look to clear it. There's the Chaos Meteor hammering down onto Arteezy. The chains from Envy catching him out. Our Tor's going to fall. And now they're looking for more. Remnant digging into the trees. Trying to chase down PPD. He's got a third one. And here we go with the voice from Puppy. They'll bring down the Witch Doctor as well. They find the two of them. Because meanwhile, Misery did end up going down on the bottom lane to the rest of EG, but that's two kills for Secret on the top.
Oh! Nicely done.
I've seen a few fingers in my time, and that was one of the best ones. Twilight died.
This is now a rated R cast.
This guy owns an MVP. He needs an MVP somewhere down the line. He didn't get it in game one, and he played his heart out. He's playing for it this game, and here we go. Pi setting it up for Envy to come through. And Envy, he's going to get spinned up by Fear here. This is a shot! Weeheart! On point! And Envy, let's see if you want anything else here. Fear's going to stick around. There's going to be a TP down from Universe. We'll see if they can do anything about this Ember Spirit. There's no Flame Guard for 10 seconds. Fear, he's going to look to try and set something up here with the stump up. Envy! Envy, he's got the reactions. He's out of there. A 6-1, a Pylite die. I mean, what's the money looking like for this Lion now? He must have that. Ah, he went for the Arcanes, okay. He was still winning that when he was saving up the money initially. Well, level 7, 202. Smart stuff here from the Lion.
Yeah, I gotta say, Pai Lai Dai has probably been one of the most consistent support players throughout the entirety of Shanghai. Even in the group stage when we were casting them, I really felt like even the games that they were losing, he always was playing well. This is probably the best form that I've seen him in a very, very long time. So, on the back of that, Secret, with a very strong showing in the early game here, 5-kill advantage. They're farming very well on their two cores, and even the Night Stalker, like, this guy's got 41 CS. Puppy's got a point booster in his inventory. Gonna see a Meteor dropped here, a little bit off the mark. But Secret, looking pretty solid.
And we're just doing his best of moments of trying to hold down and slow this push from EG. At the moment, Secret slightly with the edge. And this is the thing, if Secret can kind of hold this pace,
what a player! What a player! Every time we look at the Lion, he's doing something that's top level.
This guy is a monster, actually.
He's just outsmarting the entirety of EG.
That was, like, next level. He dropped a sentry, like, between the Tier 1 and the Tier 2 because he knew they were pushing, and now they're going for Sumail as well. Looks like he's gonna turn away. But knowing that it's very common for Nyx to go for vision plays, he's just dropping a sentry between the Tier 1 and the Tier 2, dropping on the high ground, spots the Nyx right away and just hexes him. That's gotta feel pretty bad.
It's only gonna feel pretty good for Pi.
Yeah.
He's gonna be in his element at the moment, and now be part of a bit of a pick-off here. RTZ being surrounded by three of the members of Secret. Take target as well. No help for Artur. He's down, Puppy, with the final slap to the kid. 7-1, Secret. They're stepping it up this match, and EG, they need to come out with some answers sometime soon.
I still feel like this entire draft, up to the fourth pick, I thought it was really solid from EG, and as Cinder was saying, it seemed like one of the closer drafts, but as soon as I saw the Pugna, I was just like, I get it on the mids, you want to try to pressure, you want to have the ability to push towers, but he's not even that good at killing Roshan. Throughout the entire series, it seems to be the common theme that the team, EG, they've had Dire every game, correct? So, if you pick a hero that secures you Roshan in every single game, Sven is pretty good at it, but maybe not the best. You want another hero who can kind of complement that, and I'm not really sure if Pugna is that hero.
Eyes on Misery Fear, going for the burst, and he's got it. Nice pick off there for the Nyx Assassin. Exactly what EG need at this point. Somehow, going to be slowed down here by the Void. There's going to be TPs coming through as well. It's dropped down the ward here to slow Secret's chase. And now just soak up the gold for that one. But, I mean, Fear, he's got to do stuff like that, and they just need to find the pickoffs they can, and getting the golden EXP on the Nyx is never going to be a bad thing here for EG.
The big question is, what item does he buy? Does he go Blink? Does he go Dagon? I mean, Blink is kind of the go-to, right? You put yourself in the middle of the team fight, you can use it to disjoint the Ember Spirit by using Flame Guard to proc Carapace. It can be pretty strong.
Mid lane, EG, nice. On the verge of losing the Tier 1 here, Secret. Hanging about, EG are going to be there if Secret do decide to push the issue, but Secret are just playing this one sensibly.
No reason to have a huge commitment when you know that you're kind of leading in the early game. Well, we do say that, and Arteezy is going to be taking a pretty good chunk of Ancients right now. Is he rushing BKB? I think he is.
I think this is going to be the Tread Sanj build again, isn't it?
But he's got a lot of money. I figure you would just buy the item if you were going to buy it, you know?
We still are we just trying to get some vision around it. It's going to be the Blink.
Oh, he goes Blink. Okay.
All right.
I like it. The aggressive choice.
I would look to try and catch out Envy. Of course, Envy going for that classic Aquila box build. So is rather vulnerable if EG can get the jump on him. And that's why the Blink Sven is going to be... Well, it certainly has the potential to be incredibly effective in terms of shutting down Envy at this point of the game. But Envy, We know how smart he plays it. Once he gets the bots up, his map awareness should be good enough to keep him in the right places at the right time.
I think it's easier for the Nyx to jump him, actually, than the Sven, because the Nyx can bypass vision, where the Sven is going to have to potentially walk past a ward and then blink, depending on where Envy is. And plus, you can just Carapace when you're in Mendetta now, so it's really nice when he's using Flame Guard to point.
Oh, moving in onto Zemao, the finger straight up with Pylai Dai! Pylai Dai on a killing spree, 3-0-3 on the Lion. And we'll get the deny there on the mid tier 1, but... if this continues like this and Pylai Dai doesn't get MVP, I'm done.
Dude, the guy is honestly playing out of his mind. He's died, I think, one time in the last two games so far. Oh, that was so close, actually.
Oh, he tried to go for the phase damage. Nearly. Ever so nearly.
Man, Courier OP. Please nerf. Too much armor. But still, game not over by any means.
Oh, he's had enough of Pi. He's had enough of Pi, but Pi, he's had enough of Artur.
Doesn't care, dude. He's out.
Oh, Pi Line Die. He's just teasing EG at this point.
I think that this is going to become like one of those heroes that you might want to think about respect banning against Secret in like the second phase, or maybe even like last ban if Pi doesn't have his hero yet. He just honestly plays a phenomenal Lion. It's very reminiscent of watching like Lanham, for example, when he used to play Lion quite a bit. I know he still does, but it's a bit more prevalent a couple of weeks back. And EG have yet to secure their first Roshan. It's about 17 minutes in. They do have mech up. I think it's going to be more down to the Sven actually getting his item timing. I think going Blink than BKB is probably the best teamfight choice that he can go for. Good cancel on that DP. I don't think that was the play.
They'll pop the fort, of course, but these tier ones still going to go down. You've got the Misery doing the split push game. He's up on the top lane. WTP's coming through, Artur is there, and he does have that blink to try and catch out Misery, and he fights for the... he got the wrong tree! He got the wrong tree, that man's not a lumberjack!
It's really hard, actually, to get the right tree in that situation, because you have to get the one that's, like, on the farthest left, so you can get a straight line in, because there are other trees from the jungle blocking you.
Unfortunate there for Arteezy.
Yeah.
And 8-2 at the moment, EG trying to do their best to hold on to the pace that Secret have started to try and set. It's 8-2, and as you're looking at the net worth, the fact that Weehaw is continuing to have pretty much the ideal game in his eyes as this invoker. He's top of the board, and Envy, you can tell he's getting into the zone. He's finding the rhythm, he's finding the areas to farm in. And EG, they're going to need to come out with some big catches if they want to kind of shut this down and slow down the progression of Secret's heroes.
They're going to have a pretty big power spike when Arteezy finishes the next item. I think he's going SNY. He's going to delay the BKB a bit. But I don't... Honestly, like, I understand why people go SNY on this hero so much. It's just a very... It's a balanced item, right? Because you get movement speed, you get teamfight potential, you get health. It's pretty much everything that Sven needs. But at the same time, they have so much control for him in the teamfights, and his team is also built to fight. Like, you don't pick Darkseer, Nyx, and then a Pugna to sit back and farm for the late game. Like, you want to be the ones dictating the pace.
Yeah, can they catch out Envy here? Fear setting something up. Envy's incredibly deep. The spike passes. He can just step it around this now. Oh, Envy.
That was... a really big misplay, actually. There's no way you should not hit that follow-up stun. It's over a 1 second stun. Fear actually did something very similar earlier when they were fighting bottom. That was just a mechanical mistake. There's no way he should be alive right now.
Absolutely, just overestimating the stun duration of the spike carapace, as you said, not falling for in time. And it's costing EG some big kills. Envy, 1300 into the two swords required for the Battle Fury. Things going from kind of good to better here for Secret.
Very uncharacteristic of Fear to do something like that. Like, normally he is one of the most solid players you'll ever see, right? You don't see mechanical mistakes out of him very often, so maybe EG feeling the pressure a bit here in game number 3. I mean, Puppy's almost got Aghanims. It's 20 minutes in, the guy is only 300 gold away. We were talking about the vision game and how important it was in being able to take successful teamfights for Secret in one of the games in the series, and sooner or later, EG aren't going to have much of a map left when you're playing against a Night Stalker. He's going to be, you know, level 11 soon. He's got Aghanims. EG know they got to do something, and they're going to go for a smoke here, but it's not going to find anyone.
It certainly isn't. Misery is going to be the one TPing into the area. I mean, Roshan is up, but EG, they just don't really have the lineup to go for it. So it's not really going to be on the menu for them. Secret as well, they do have an invoker, so they do have some kind of potential. And of course, with the Exalt build, they can themselves try for Roshan. But at this point, that's not really what they need. They're just happy trying to keep space here for Envy to continue to farm, get his Battle Fury complete. Nostrum now done onto Misery, so he's going to be even more fit for fighting. Just across the board for all five heroes of Secret, things looking very solid at the moment.
Yeah, the way that they're playing this is just very calm, calculated. They now have the vision from the Night Stalker Egg, so they can pick and choose their fights whenever they want. I mean, their tier 3 is being sieged right now top, and Secret are also looking for a fight.
Yep, Secret, they're ready to fight at the bottom. Puppy looking for some kind of a wraparound here. He's trying to get himself in, and he'll go on to PPD. Silences up Samael. Highlight-Eye moving forward as well. Let's see if he can catch them out with something big. He still hasn't got the blink yet, but he doesn't need to throw it on to BBD. Finger up as well. BBD caught out and he's down. The setup now with the Nord Oxus out. Samael trying
tries to get a one steal out, it doesn't matter, he's down as well. Double kill for Weeha. And also at the same time, can they get themselves anymore? They're still chasing. They're chasing Universe. Puppy, he's got the point, and here comes the backup. Misery, TP's in, lays down the Sprout. Universe trapped amongst the trees. Another kill for Secret, 12 for 2. And what is happening in this game, 3 for EG? It is an absolute mess, Andy.
This has got to be one of the more dominant performances I've seen against EG.
Artur, he's playing with envy here. A little bit of cat and mouse. My goodness. That's about a fury done now for envy. And straight into Roshan. Talked about the potential that they can take this with Weehar's four spirits. And no way that EG could stop this. And this is a total reversal of the story of game two.
I don't think that you can pick Sumail a hero like Pugna and not help him in a matchup where you're playing against Furion. I think that's honestly the biggest problem that they've had this game, is just how badly the mid matchup went for them. And the fact that they didn't have anything to shut down the Prophet in lane, their supports were pretty greedy, and at the end of the day, like, Secret have superior vision, they have superior mobility, and because of the fact that they've reached a mid-game stage where the laning phase went so comfortably for them, I mean, this Nature's Prophet, he felt so confident, he bought a freaking Midas.
He's had a great time.
Like,
he's living the game.
Yeah, it's really rough for EG, because even if they delay, the only person on their team who's going to continually get a good amount of farm is going to be the Sven. The Pugna has yet to break 100 CS in a 23-minute game. That is ridiculously low farm for a hero like that, who does need items to be able to tank himself up, so...
Looking to the top. If they can catch him here, they do have that invis on RTZ. It could be what they need to catch him out. That's going to be the Remnant dropped out, but no! Oh no, he's running straight into it! And they've got the catch! They've got the chain stuns! Envy ball cannon, and that's the kill that EG needs to bring themselves back into this. RTZ credited with the gold. And Envy just not aware there, and EG with the perfect wraparound.
Yeah, that was just really nicely executed. And that's what you expect to happen, like bottom lane, for example, when they were jumping on him too. You expect the Carapace into the stun into a guaranteed kill, but that is going to be his first death this game. He already has the Battle Fury and the bots completed.
Artur, he's in trouble! Highlight Eye setting it up with the stun! Sunstrike in! RTZ going down! Secret find it and Pi with the initiation. Getting that revenge kill for losing his envy brother.
Man, the Night Stalker, Aghanim's gem, already. Only one ward standing on EG's side of the map right now against a team with a Furion. That's...
Misery. Okay, Misery. He's a little bit in a sticky position. He has got back up. Weeha is there to help him. The Dev will take it laid down by PPD and Misery. He's almost going to fall in the vacuum as well. He's in trouble as well. EG, maybe with a turnaround, they're going to find Puppy. Sumail will go down. Weeha trying to clear up on the back lines, but it's a 2-for-2 trade at the moment. Now Envy joining the fight. Stay able to fight Carapace. Will hold Envy in place. Gets the stun out as well. Weeha barely there at the moment. Take a lot of damage here from the wall illusions. Highlight Eye coming in. They get the change. The Hex on the bit. Deafening Blast. White Spear off the face of the Earth. And Envy, he's not done. He's looking for more chains. Oh, now of cooldown. Doesn't quite get the latch onto PPD. Bit off there with the timing, but still making it a 3-for-2 trade. Secret able to come out on top of that one.
The really big thing, though, is that EG walk away with the gem. That's huge. I think Universe picked it up and then walked away with it after Puppy died. So taking the gem away from Secret, that means they can maybe get out a ward or two and actually give themselves some kind of vision. Obviously, Secret do end up with the Roshan as well, so they have momentum on their side for the time being, but at this stage in the game, EG have to take the small victories when they can get them. And having the gem, preventing the dewarding coming out from Secret, and allowing themselves to establish some kind of map presence is going to be crucial if they want to try to come back in this game.
We now with 2.7k on top of the Ags, 25 minutes in, 16,000 net worth on the Invoker. At the same time, we did just see off the back of that, RTZ was able to surmount quite a good bit of gold. 3.6k on the Sven. A lot of pressure on the boy to pick up something big here. What is RTZ going to go for his next time? Does he have to get the BKB, or can he bypass that and go for something a little bit more aggressive?
I think BKB gives him too much of a power spike to pass up. I mean, they're at a 10-kill deficit. He probably feels pretty comfortable with his level of farm, as well he should. He still has a really good amount of CS, and he's got enough almost for the entirety of the BKB right now. If you have 10-second BKB, you get Ion Shelled, you know, you get Surge, you blink in with your BKB, you just stun a target, that hero should die. especially when you have God Strength on. So I think that is going to be the play here for EG. Try to get your team fights going with a fresh BKB on the Sven.
We got EG. All towards the mid lane. Secret already waiting. Everybody back up now. Envy. He's got 2k. Very close to having the money there for Crystalis. And he has a DD bottled as well. So if EG do decide to push, he's going to be there with the big hard hitting Sleight of Fist. Now still hanging around here, EG. He's going to be the one to come out. Arteezy. He's going to clear out the Ancients. It looks like nothing big going to kick off. And indeed, yeah, as you said, Arteezy just playing it safe, getting that BKB. And hoping that the power spike is going to be enough to find some more big team fight victories here for the side of Evil Geniuses.
Yeah, I mean, the amount that he gets from it now is bigger than if he had just bought it right after the Dominator and the Blink, because you also have the SNY inside of the team fights to carry your mobility, allow you to potentially get a maim and just chase people down. This is going to be probably one of the strongest points in the game for EG for a long time. And I mean, we say that, but unfortunately they are terrified because of the fact that Secret do have another gem. And they do have the Aghanim still up on the Nightstalker. They just can't afford to go out of their base when they can't see.
Yeah, they cannot leave the base here. Because Secret, they're going to be right ready to jump. Hopefully with that nighttime vision, he can spot them.
This could potentially be the turnaround time for EG, though. Because if you look at Secret's lineup, they have no BKB disable whatsoever.
Just teasing them there with the DD Weaver. Got the combo down to surveil! One quick, swift throw there from the Invoker, bringing the Pugna out of the game.
Link up.
Oh, Envy! He's going in! Envy! Envy! What are you doing? Oh, no! Oh my goodness! Jackie Mao, he does it again! But it is not a good thing.
I have no idea what that was.
Alright. You thought the range creep mana void was bad.
I actually have no idea why I did that. Because what he did the first time is he goes for a Searing Chains to secure a Sunstrike and a Meteor, right? Like, that one made sense, because he knows that the heroes are in the front line of the base.
But they've just got so many stuns on each. The control's gonna be there.
Yeah, it's not just the fact that they have the control, it's the fact that Wii doesn't have his spells up. So who's your follow-up hero, you know? It's like, okay, I want to go in, try to harass, maybe go back to my Remnant, fine. Maybe force them back a little bit so we can get chip damage on the tower, but I promise you, your life is more important than, getting one Sleight of Fist off.
Well, on the plus side for Secret, that one death is going to be too costly, as they do still have the lead in this game, but they can't let that happen many more times, because EG, they'll be quick to really push to the issue and turn around these fights and try and take advantage of Secret when they are a hero or two down. And eyes at the moment around the Roche bit. EG still playing it safe. And Secret, I'm sure they'll try and pull the reins in on Jackie next time they go for a push.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Puppy turned to him when he did that, and he just gave him a look, and he's like, my bad, I won't do that again. It's just fortunate, actually, for Secret that there was no real big objective up during that time. Like, if Roshan had been alive, for example, it might have been something that EG could have capitalized on, but as it stands right now, they're just going to be content to, not going in, not yet.
So someone wants to do some mail. Making a beeline straight for the mid lane, but Secret, they don't want to fight here with EGM, the high ground advantage from the jungle. Keeping it safe. Samael has nearly got that Aghanim's done. But at the same time, it's just a question of how much that's going to do for him, because we're seeing just this Pugna just getting... He gets blown up so easily by the combos of the heroes in Secret, like the Invoker.
Yeah, he definitely needs BKB, but he's opting for the Aghanim's first. I like the life drain, it's really strong. We saw it actually utilized with OG, who did it with the Lone Druid, I think it was. They showed that they can slow siege with it. It has a lot of uses, and plus, it's very good at harassing people. And when you get the Aether Lens on top of it as well, the range is insane, and you can just drain forever. So it's a really nice combination. The only problem is, if he gets disabled once, he's just dead. Like, there's nothing they can do to save him. A mech is not going to be enough.
EG. So if they can catch out Secret here as they come over to their half of the map. Warp. Puppy straight away with the D-Warp. But oh, the Warp bait, they'll say we'll take this one. RPG jumps in this game using the active of the BKB and will find the kill. Puppy buys back. Misery. Oh, he's looking for the Curry. He's going to find it. Nice Curry start there for Misery. Finger on the fear. Double kill for Arteezy. No, he takes down Pylai Dine. Arteezy's trying to fight for this one. The Deadpool getting laid down. Pummeling in until we are. But Arteezy falling ground will drop. They'll get the kill into our door. And now they're trying to chase Evermore. PPD with a TP out to Mel. He's also on the escape route, and he's going to make it. But it looks like Universe is... Oh, make note, they've got the yours. Not as much luck here from Darkseer. Universe giving his life as well. Secret did buy back on Buffy for the clear out three heroes. And EG are put back into their place.
This has got to be the best I've seen Secret look the entire tournament. Like, this particular game, the coordination that they have, I mean, sure, there's been a couple of individual mistakes throughout the series, but this is the best Dota that I think I've seen them play so far.
And here we have it. Onto the high ground, there'll be a buyback straight away from Artur. It's our Secret, they'll respect that. They just back off. They're happy with baiting that one out. EG will defend the base, but Secret slowly trying to push them into more and more of an awkward position this game.
Now, EG are kind of running out of options. Their lineup has a very weird peak where, like, your Nyx maybe has, like, Blink Initiation, which Fear has right now. Your Pugna has a BKB, and your Sven has enough items to pop BKB and be able to just hit people in teamfights. So it's kind of roughly around right now. Sure, your Sven can still get crit, he can still get the AC, but the longer the game goes, it's not about how well your hero scales, it is Secret's. Because they're going to have so much mobility, so many options for the late game, like Furion and Ember Spirit split push. They have a decent amount of teamfight with Wii getting higher level, Fear.
Yeah,
he does not have a gem anymore, so he's not going to see Wii.
Pop 8. No, he does have a gem. He knows Fizz.
Oh,
there.
God.
Walking straight into it. Oh, that's a nice blink. Straight out. Well, TZ, hello. He's coming straight into this one. Nice one. We'll get laid down.
It's actually very good that he didn't BKB there. He was trying to bait it out by casting Cold Snap, but Artur didn't Cold
Snap. Oh, MB, nice. James onto Artesian Fizz. Freezer pop. Pylite die. Oh, no. Oh, Pi. He's been having such a good series, but that one was a bit of a giveaway.
The base?
Ah, misery. Don't ever forget about the Nature's Prophet. TP backs are coming through. The whole universe in place. They'll combo him in. Sunstrike and the Meteor flying down. Envy's there to shut him off. They'll take down Universe. Misery will lose his life. BPD and Fear are able to take him down, but they still get the range rank secret. URTZ popping the BKB. Aiming his attention towards Puppy. Now backs up. Looking for Envy. Envy will be able to get himself out of a remnant. We are pops the BKB sticking around, but he's got the Ghost Ward. Now he's turning. Is he going to try and fight this one up? No. RTZ. RTZ. Cold snapped up. Can he get a blink in onto this? Yes, he can. To try and find this one, we are going to get away the Storm Hammer. It will come out. RTZ. He's a few hits onto this one. We are in trouble. All the Deputy Birds. We are toying with RTZ here. Oh, he's going to be careful here. Force Spirit coming in. Oh, no, no. Oh, Artur there with a hell of a domination. Force Spirit is nearly killing the Invoker. Twilight die, he's there with the finger, the Sunstrike's laid down, but it doesn't matter. They've already got the kill into Samael. Envy jumping forward, looking for RTZ. Possible on him back, gets the slight, the change, onto the Witch Doctor. PBD hexed up by Twilight die. PBD trying to get himself out of there, there's no escape for the boy. He's dead, double kill for Envy. An incredibly messy fight, but Secret, they certainly do it. They certainly do it, they take the fight, they take the range racks. And now, they're all three of their cores at the top of the net worth board, and now they look for Roshan. Things looking up and up for Secret. EG, they need to come out with the big plays, because it certainly looks like the struggle is becoming even harder here for the Americans.
Yeah, this is becoming very difficult for EG. They're going to try to contest this.
The big plays. This could be huge. If EG can do something, oh, they did it! Oh, the perfect setup for RTZ! It's a double kill, Misery, and we are to fall! Can they find themselves more? And the meanwhile, Envy, he's taking a page out of Misery's book. He's looking for the objectives. He's just hitting away at the racks. He's got a Daedalus done. He's now out of there. But that catch out round the pit. Fear coming in, knowing he was safe to set that one up. And RTZ had more than enough damage to deal with it. Artur, be careful here. Envy, oh, but they got the chase done. Can RTZ get the damage through? He's trying to get the hit to that Envy. He is able to slide and get himself out of a remnant. RTZ chasing him for more, bleaks into the lane, won't be able to catch anyone out with a Storm Hammer. There is now an Axe done on Fear's Nyx Assassin, and they may be 17,500 ahead, but EG still proving that they can take a fight against this very rich side of Secret. They're looking for Envy. Fear, is he going to go for it into the blind? He's not. Envy will be able to get himself TP'd out from the tree line. But this game, it's not quite over yet, Draskull. EG, they're trying to hit back as hard as they can.
Yeah, they're still very reliant on the Sven's damage. That's the biggest thing. If you look at Secret's lineup, they can take the drawn out fights because they don't have anyone who's really ultimate reliant except for Pi. Puffy!
Oh, Puffy down! Oh no! The death form's there! There's no hope for the boys! Drag back in by Universe! And that's your gem. Envy! Oh no, Envy! Not like this! Envy! EG! Oh! They pick themselves up, they're grabbing Secret by the neck and they're chucking them about. Oh, Misery and Wii. Well, we're trying to make something happen up top. Fear's coming in. See if they can find anything here. But I haven't got eyes on Weehar. Fear carrying the gem at the moment for the side, but Weehar's way out of there. You got the Treant, slowly chipping away at these melee racks. But this game certainly, it's been turned up to 11 by both sides. Octarine now done on Invoker. 22 to 14. And let's actually, can we have a look at the net worth graph? What we got at the moment? It's starting to swing back round. It's still very much favoring Secret. Fit. And just seeing if he can set something up. He's looking at Misery here. And
what
now,
PPD
throws in a paralyzing cast. Misery falling low. The Semeo from the low ground. Look at that life train. He'll take the kill on to Misery. EG hitting back incredibly hard here. Secret needs to recompose themselves and do something because the anger of EG is lashing out.
Man, they just keep getting picked off so many times. Like, two times Envy has died in very crucial situations where not only are EG going to be able to get this tier 2, but they're also going to be able to get Roche if they want.
Oh boy.
If they want to try to force a buyback out of Misery, I don't know if it's worth doing this over just going for the Roshan kill. They even both have vision of the rune bottom, and it's a DD. EG is trying to force everything out of Secret right now.
Look at this. Samael doing the classic backline, just giving RTZ his power. Take my power, Arthur. Take my power. He's got to be careful how much he does give away, though.
Wow, RTZ. They're actually going to get this.
All right. Envy in the slight. Okay, Puppy's on the side trying to fly into this. A stun fly through, but RTZ pops a PKB, jumps at the pile, I die. They'll lose the mail on the Pugna here. And so they can get him off. With a setup, just change on the BBD, stopping the TP. TPD looks to be the one to go down the side. As a pile, I die, just throwing Arthur. Hits the hex out the stun as well. Pepsi Glass line for RTZ down. Double kill for Envy. They hold on to it. Three of the heroes of EG now on the sideline, but they do have buyback available. It looks like Secret will head for the safe play, head for the pit. But EG overstaying their welcome on Secret's half of the map.
The weird part about that was RTZ didn't BKB that entire time, right? Like, he's just sitting there hitting the racks. He BKB'd at the end.
Yeah, so sorry, off
the thing, right?
Off the couple
of racks. Didn't even need to BKB at that point. He just BKB'd to ensure that the Rax died. Ends up that BKB usage gets him chased down and killed. The rest of his team can't help him. They end up giving away the Roche that they could have secured by just walking there and then coming back with a guaranteed Aegis, high grounding, and maybe not losing the fight so badly. I still feel like it would have been the better choice to just go for the safer play and then go for the Rax after the fact, even though they got their objective, because now they're fighting into Secret, and Secret are the ones with the Roche advantage.
And the question is, can they try and force RTZ to buy back the Leisure House? So straight away, that'll be the buyback from RTZ. And again, looks like Secret. I don't want to try and make the mistake of fighting too brashly into the full lineup of EG. They will back off a lot of money on this Nature's Prophet. 5.3k for Misery at the moment in the bank.
I would imagine that he goes for Hex, and then maybe finishes up the Mjolnir eventually. So most likely going to be seeing him either get rid of the drums or get rid of the Midas suit.
EG thinking very carefully about how they want to try and make a move from outside of their base. They're going to stay at home at the moment, waiting for Secret to show their hand.
And this is the worst situation for EG to be in. Like, in terms of what their lineup can accomplish, if you're all inside of your base, all three of your lanes are pushed in, your wave clear consists of an ion shell and a stun, which is still okay, but you're never really going to be able to get out of the base without being scouted, especially when it's nighttime and there's a Night Stalker with an Aghanim's and a gem available. Being constricted is what EG don't want. Like, Secret's lineup is very good at holding control of the map once they have it, just because of their vision control.
Oh, he's just teasing with him here. Fear will find the setup with a stun.
needs some backup on the way, and with the Axe, he's setting up the RPG for it. Oh, Pi's coming as well, and opens up his line. Look at the liner now. Some RTG cast down, we are here. Maxwell will be dropped down, and looks like we are now. The Hex from Universe brings it back as well with the Vacuum of Universe. Allows them to catch out We Heart once. Let's see if they can do it again here. They'll look for it. We Heart gets out the tornado and he will run. But as you said, top lane. Action's happening. Envy looking for the wrap. Fortification will come out. Bottom lane as well. The Treant's doing work. EG, home is in trouble. The TP's now coming back somehow. He's been put out. It's been cancelled here. Puppy looking for the kill with the help of We Heart. They'll get it. They'll bring down Sumail. EG will hold on some of the racks. They've got eyes on to Envy. They've got eyes on Tempi, they've got the control.
Misery's going for
the They're looking for having the death one to go by with the vacuum. No messing around to kill it. And Misery, as you said, will find the melee rack by the looks of it. He's going to get it. He will. Misery gets off the rack, gets off the blink. He's out of there. So they may lose Envy, but they're getting the objectives.
Oh, man. This game's getting really intense. Later it goes, the more mistakes are going to matter. And EG just getting pulled out of position again by the Fury and by the Ember. Just the sheer mobility of Secret's lineup is becoming too much for them to handle. And this is a situation that would never arise if they had just gone for Roshan instead of pushing mid. All of this could have been avoided. The EG is just... In the two games that I feel like... You know, obviously it's not over yet, but I think Secret have a pretty good advantage right now. But in the two games they could potentially lose, both games, EG decide to go for something that is extremely risky when there's a very safe play that they could do that would give them almost an assured chance to get a bigger advantage for almost no risk.
Yeah. Just trying to get some intel here from the half of the map of Secret. See if he can find any way to lead in. But at this point, you've got to give credit to Misery. He's been looking for those homies, finding it every time. Bottom lane, Puppy. Pop out the ornament. He is still holding that gem here. Of course, saw Fear coming into the near vicinity. And EG will hold back up for the time being. 26-17. Considering EG's start, they are certainly giving us a hell of a game here, holding on against Secret. And there is definitely potential with RTZ Sven, with the setup from Universe on his Darkseer.
Yeah, I think there's going to be a Daedalus soon too on the Sven, so you think he does some damage now? Just wait until he gets his next item. That's going to be some serious pain that he's dishing out for sure. But EG really only have one game plan. They need to fight. Like, their lineup is made to fight, not made to split push, not made to fight in these, like, kind of drawn out situations where they're reliant on their ultimates more than Secret.
Well, they can spot Fear out. Oh, Fear all day. We are from leading head to BKB, straight up to Fear. Hex for Autopilot, let him get him. Look at him over the wall. Ryan gets after his destroyer. PBD lays out the corner. We'll get kept in the RTZ. Moving in Envy. He's got the BKB. Run up to the high ground. Envy, he's on a cliff. He's on a cliff. Oh, they think he's got past the cliff. Envy's just sitting there watching them all. They don't know he's up there. And are they going to work? No, they think he's gone. Oh, Envy. Envy.
What?
What are you doing? What are you? Oh, my. Oh. Oh.
I'm actually speechless. He had absolutely no vision.
Wow, here comes the rest of Secret. They're gonna try and redeem whatever he tried to start. They'll get Fear. Now they'll look for some male. Weehawk trying his best to play and carry on as Invoker. Top lane Universe, forcing back Misery. My goodness. I mean, you can always expect these kind of get. Okay. Alrighty, Envy. I'm sorry, Mr. Easy. Art's easy. He's going to be the one getting the rapier pick up first.
I mean, this is one way to get damage.
And this is one way to win the crowd over. We've heard already, there's a lot of Secret fans in the audience, but when RTZ picks up a rapier, you can't help but love it.
I feel like... I mean, obviously, it's going to make him hit ridiculously hard. But at the same time, is Sven the hero who needs a rapier? I mean, God's Reign gives him pretty much rapier levels of damage, and crit makes it so... And that one hit, if you do get it, you pretty much just one-shot whoever you're hitting. I mean, I'm not going to go too far into it because I feel like this is a situation where they obviously are feeling the pressure and they're going for the biggest bang for the buck item. and Rapier is definitely that item if you want to buy it. It's just all going to be down to, can he actually get in range and hit heroes? That is pretty much how EG win the fight. Control something so Artur can hit it.
All eyes on Arteezy at the moment. These fights kick off. So the 15k lead here for Secret. We're going to have MB back in the game now. He's still got a hell of a lot of money, 3.7k. Mid lane, the cheers are coming out there as Carsi nearly finished up the tier 3, MB will do it. There we go, he's getting the applause now, Jackie. The atmosphere here in the arena, absolutely stepping up. The crowd, just as important, yes, everyone. This game could go both ways.
It's really scary fighting into EG's lineup because even though you're this far ahead, you know that one back stun with Arteezy having God Strength just means that you could lose a team fight in two auto attacks. I mean, that's really how much damage he's gonna do. Yeah, I mean, the stats are pretty much just saying what I was talking about earlier, just the fact that Sven is a very unconventional Rapier carrier. Typically, you want to put it on a hero that is, like, range, has ways of hitting multiple heroes at the same time, so in that sense, Medusa and Gyro are, like, the go-tos when you think of Rapier carriers. Sven, not so common, but I'm sure he's done the math. He knows what it's worth, what its value is in this game.
Great in bots as well now, Arteezy, so he's going to be ready to fight at a moment's notice. It's going to mean there's no buyback on Arteezy, but of course, I guess when you go full in on a Rapier, yeah, it's all in or bust here.
Yeah. There's no question that this is like... The next item he buys is Satanic. That's the only thing he can really get in this situation. I mean, maybe he sells Dominator and goes crit and just says YOLO. Who knows? It's possible.
Yeah, they have got the Vlads on PCD, so Lifesteal will still be there for him.
Yeah.
That's definitely a possibility.
Roshan's being taken here by Secret and EG just don't have the vision. Like, they cannot see anything.
Oh, top lane, Pylite Eye. It'll get caught out there.
That's fine, actually. Like, that kill doesn't really matter much just because of the fact that Secret are gonna get this Rosh, even if they have to wait for Pi to resurrect, it's only 60 seconds. It's also AC finished up now on Misery.
Now, the thing is, Envy, he's seen Arteezy's Rapier, and I think he's gone, Puppy, I want one of those. The question is that the play here for Envy? Does he need to pick up a Rapier himself this game? He's got 6.1k in the bank. It certainly could be on the table for him.
It could be another crit, could be not a Battle Fury, Rapier like you said. It's possible. I think Ember is actually a very good Rapier carrier, even in comparison to a hero like Sven, clearly. Of the two, Ember is way better at a Rapier carrier, but it's one of those things where you have to ask yourself, do I need it? Like, look at the state of the game right now. EG are having a hard time keeping even one of their lanes pushed. All of their Raxes are exposed. They have no way of... Look at these creeps! They're just trees everywhere, man.
Misery's just sending them all in onto the base. Each and every time, just slowly doing that little bit more here to the Rax.
This is a game state where I would say a lot of the time, Ember feels pressured to buy a Rapier, but this game is not that bad. Like, this is a game where I think you could just get away with going another crit or, you know, even buying something like a Lincoln's to prevent a Sven stun. Like, there are a lot of choices for him. I think Rapier is a needless risk.
Nice, so just upgrade the bot set on, also on Weehar as well. So...
More mobility on top of what Secret already have, which is insane.
Okay. Pi's able to kind of get himself out onto the map, maybe find himself a pickoff. Instantly, you're going to have backup from both the Ember and the Invoker. 28 to 20, we're 50 minutes into this game. The series, overall, it's been an incredibly eventful one. Both teams have been their ups and downs. And just this culmination in game three, where it can go either way. It really can.
Yep. It just comes down to that one big team fight. If EG can get it, they can get the control, they can get any kind of combo play off. Like, we haven't really talked much about PPD, but he's had some nice death wards. The biggest issue that they're having right now is, if he had Aghanims, for example, they would have another really high damage output hero on their team that he could have to worry about, but because he doesn't have that luxury just yet, he's okay, now he's got it. He's not even going to save for buyback. I say he might save for buyback here, but he might be under the assumption that if a teamfight is lost at this point, they're just going to lose their base no matter what. They only have three Raxes remaining, one of which is a ranged Rax, which will eventually get chipped out by either Treants or, you know, Secret going high ground.
And that is, I believe, RTZ's Satanic done. He's just got the courier sent out, looking for the reverse. You know, he's not going to buy the reverse as of
yet. He can't buy it. Didn't have buyback. That's the problem. He needs another 1,500 gold, give or take, before he can finish it. Oh, no.
He's got a rapier, has he? Oh, puppy.
Oh, that is so awful, actually. The question is, did he see what was on it?
Ah, oh, nice puppy. Puppy sees everything. Now, off the back of that, they know there's no Satanic for 3 minutes. They know that probably after that purchase, Arthur's not going to have buyback available. So this could be the time for them to fight. A nice opening here for Secret. They've got to kill Arthur. He's on the top lane, a bit on his own here. And in fact, if they can get the jump in, yeah, look at the Hex off. Arteezy needs backup. The finger down. Arteezy falling low. That would probably be Kenny. Both have a strong mystery, which is joining everybody. Pi Ladai gets Hexed up himself. They'll take down Pi. They're able to keep Arteezy safe there. Won't be as lucky. Still getting bursted down. Fortification coming out, Arteezy. He's looking to push Misery outside of the base, and oh, Misery sprouts himself in time. He's gonna lift the Khalifa around, the Silence of the Khalifa does get it. Positions himself, mid lane, we are the BKB, push the Misery on the Rax, get it, the mid lane of Rax are down. Buyback now for the Nation's problem, Misery trying to get them back in the ball, getting dropped, Puppy now on the retreat, the stun, and he's down, but it's for the Aegis. Can he fight well off the back of this? He has got his team around, he's gonna get the slide up fist out here, Remnants away, Envy will escape. Gets himself out of there. But they do lose the mid racks. Only half of the top ones remaining here for EG.
This is such a hard game for EG to play in this position. They just don't have the heroes to deal with the Rhett. All they have is, they have a Blink Initiator, they got the Nyx, which is fine, but they're really lacking the wave clear and the ability to gain the map control back. Against the Nightstalker, being constricted for this long, you just eventually lose out on the farm game. The only person on AG who's really getting a ton out of this is the Sven. And the Sven is, he's basically maxed out.
Well, Lane, we are just playing games with RTZ Universe. Trying to control them. Got Puppy. Eyes onto PPD, won't be able to follow through on that one. It's worth noting as well. So it's a big iron pickups. Refreshers now done on Misery. Refresher, Ags, Octarine, AC.
This is just gross.
They're loving that.
And not even going for the Hex, just don't even need the disable. Screw it, just pushing all the lanes even harder. Rapier number two, okay.
Okie dokie. Alright, RTZ. Double Rapier spam, Envy. Envy, does he want to play games with this? Playing with fire, quite literally. Needs to be very careful how RTZ gets. On the big screen here in the stadium, they've got a lovely cam on RTZ's face at the moment. And he's so focused. He's right in the game. Envy though, is he? He gets hexed up. Envy's hexed up. RTZ coming through late down the center. RTZ trying to get to Envy. He's trying to get towards Envy. And at the moment, just kiting each other out. We are pushing the back of the same time. Top lane. Home in trouble for EG. This could be Megas. Misery doing it. They need to get back. They're not going to. That's the top lane. Rex down. They're planning out PPD. Next up, we are laying down the cold stab. Universe coming forward. It gets the faction back up to Invoker. Now X him up it. Deadforce laid down. They need to do something about Weezer. He's coming as well. They'll get the kill onto Weezer. EG, they are dealing with Mega Creeps now, though. But RTZ's got double rapier. They're going to go straight down the mid and try and finish this one. There'll be a buyback from the Invoker.
This is it for them. They have to win here.
Oh, my goodness. They've got a goal in, no fortification available for EG. There is a fort here for Secret. Arthur, God strength up. Screw the effigies, onto the tier 4s. Look at the Buffy, Buffy getting eggs up here. The side effect of Shane's on to Arthur. The University gets the stun out to Buffy. RTZ, got to the cell. Look at the tier 4 there. But this is the rest of EG trouble. RTZ, RTZ is dead. He's gone down. Double rapier hitting a deck here. RTZ, they've got 110 seconds. Universe pop BPD as well. MV now killing EG with RTZ's own rapier, and it's GG. They've done it. They've done it. Secret take the series 2-1. And EG, they tried their best. The double rapier didn't work out. And Misery, the whole game is slowly working down the face of EG. Oh, Andy, what a series.
I don't think you can ask for a better ending than a double Rapier Sven rushing down mid.